Hi, I'm Bill Griffith, an application engineer with Keysight Technologies, and today we're going to look at the data logger feature, which is built into our IntegraVision power analyzer. The data logging feature is used to capture all the numerical measurements from the IntegraVision power analyzer and write them to a USB stick. We can set both the interval at which the measurements are written to the USB stick as well as the duration. Let's go ahead and take a look at the data logger feature now. So the first thing you'll notice with our data logger is you can create your own file name. You can choose to have that file name incremented, or you can turn off the increment feature, which overwrites the existing data log feature. Next, we can go ahead and set both the interval, which can be as fast as 50 milliseconds, or we can change that and make it as long as 24 hours. I'm going to select 200 milliseconds. By selecting 200 milliseconds or higher, we actually get some additional measurements. We get the total harmonic distortion measurement as well as an efficiency measurement logged to our data file. Our duration can be as short as 1 second or as long as 365 days. I'm going to choose 60 seconds. Now we have our data logger set up. We'll go ahead and start. And as you can see, it's starting to capture data. And we have about 50 seconds remaining on our data logging. What we're measuring is we're measuring the dynamic power of an inverter. So we have 12 volts applied to the input. So we'll log both the input voltage as well as a current and measure its power. And we'll also look at the output, which is 120 volts AC. We'll measure both the voltage and the current of our inverter, which is driving a lamp. Okay, our data logger is complete. So we'll go ahead and pull out our USB stick, which has a CSV file on it, and we'll take a look at it on the PC. I've opened our CSV file in Excel so you can look at the file. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change the numerical format just so it's just easier for me to read. So just using Excel to pick a number format instead of the scientific notation. So the first thing you'll notice is our data is written as rows for each of our intervals. And each row is timestamped. So they are separated by 200 milliseconds. So you can see each of the rows. And then each column represents a different measurement that's captured. So as you can see, there's quite a few measurements captured for each channel. I'm going to skip to the end to look at the efficiency measurement. And I'm going to go ahead and select the efficiency measurements for over time and go ahead and graph those. So I'm going to go ahead and insert a graph. And as you can see, the efficiency varies, and this is about a 10-second duration that the efficiency varies for. So it's bouncing between 88.7 and 87.80. So something's going on with our inverter that the efficiency is changing over time. So we can look at some further data to see, you know, where that's coming from. And since efficiency is our channel 2 power divided by our channel 1 power, we can look at that power real quickly. There's lots of measurements made for each channel. So we'll take our power in watts. And if we look at this one real quick, plot it, you can see that the power is pretty consistent. It's just a little noise in there. And again, we're driving a desk lamp with it. So that makes sense. So the variation in efficiency is really not coming from the output power. So if we look back further in our data and find our power for channel 1, select the data for our power going into our inverter and plot it. Sure enough, we see the the same look to the waveform as we saw in our efficiency. So clearly something's happening on the input, which is changing the output efficiency. So, and if we were to listen to our inverter, we can actually hear a small fan that turns on every 10 seconds. So, and that's what we're seeing is as that fan turns on, it takes more power, the inverter takes more power, and then the fan turns off, and then the inverter takes less power, making it more efficient. So that's really what's causing the difference in efficiency. So we're able to use our data logging feature to find out how this inverter is changing over time. So it's kind of a neat feature. So that was a quick look at our data logging feature, a very powerful feature. All the measurements that were taken are using continuous waveform analysis. In addition to that, the measurements are gapless between the intervals we had set. So again, very powerful feature for measuring data over time. I hope you appreciate it. Thanks for watching.